What is up, guys? This is Champ, and welcome back to our UFC career mode. Today, we can either fold Jose Aldo in UFC 261, or Mirsad Bektik? Is that how his name is pronounced? Regardless, I want to fight Aldo. Last Aldo fight we had, the dude went insane on us, and if we get a fight like that, it's going to be a good one. He was crazy. I think we knocked him out in like the second round. I think that's what happened, the last Jose Aldo fight, but that fight was crazy, regardless. So our stand-up is pretty good. Do I want to work on my legs at all? I could sim for that. I might as well try to get a B there. The fight game, short training session, new rule. Don't try new restaurants during training camp. Stay close to restroom and miss a training session. Oh, so I tried a new restaurant and it gave me like an upset stomach. Okay. So only have one camp left. What do we want? Our clinch is pretty much maxed. Is it? Is it maxed? Maybe it can go... Maybe the takedown can go a little higher, but I'm gonna keep that where it is and work on my ground a bit more. Do I have any of this that I have? I have an A there. We might as well get, actually I wanted my defense up before I start working on my offense. Let's just take that A for now. That'll get me my choke defense up a little higher. There we go, so I can go up to the next level then. And I guess that's all we can actually train for this game. So it's been like 3 days, I think, since my last fight. I recorded a couple games in a row last time I recorded. And I've been busy with new zombies. Bektik actually won. He fought as well today, and he beat Lamas. There's not any other really big-name fights other than him. Ham, I guess, is a decent fight. And it's not that great. I'd say Aldo versus... Me versus Aldo is the fight of the night here, but... Got 99 stand-up, 96 clinch, 82 ground. Aldo has 100 on everything, so you know what? This dude's scary. This dude is scary as hell. I remember last time we fought him, he's got insane speed. He's got, like... He's punching with lightning. He is crazy. He's a crazy little man. I think we have the height advantage by, like, 4 or 5 inches, but he's still a crazy little guy.
It's a featherweight matchup between Pretty Boy and one of the greatest featherweights of all time. Jose Aldo.
So do we have the height advantage? I'm pretty sure we do. We have 9 years on him. We have 3 inches of height. Same reach though. We do have the height, but it doesn't really matter. He's just a compact little mean machine is what he is. Ooh, look at that.
3-round fight. White trunks for Aldo. Black trunks for Pretty Boy. Joey has worked his way up the ladder, and tonight faces the most difficult test of his mixed martial arts career.
Okay, we got lots of good punches there.
Fight the best. Well, tonight he gets that opportunity.
He's gonna make him miss and then punish him.
Oh, big uppercut! Vicious combination.
Look at his head.
Huge power in that hook.
Look at his head.
Look at his head. Boy, he is in big trouble.
Okay, he stayed up though, which is good. Good for him, but we're gonna keep knocking him down.
Powerful leg kick.
Try to trip me there. You don't try to trip me, Jose.
Oh, that was a big knee. He hurts him again with the knee.
Might as well keep trying to knee him here. I just want to break out of it, honestly. I don't want to be anywhere near Jose Aldo. This little dude scares the shit out of me.
Tagged him with that straight.
It's all over, guys. Jose Aldo. Sit down, Jose. Sit down. That was an easier fight. That was an easier fight than our first fight a million times. Jose Aldo put up a huge fight that first go around. We hurt him early, so he couldn't really do too much. The first fight we had against him, he was just rocking us with kicks.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
So I guess this is going to be another double fight episode because that fight went insanely quick. You get a good amount of fans. Longevity didn't really go up too much, so that's not too bad. We beat Jose Aldo for the second time. Nice. We only fought McGregor once, I believe, right? We fought McGregor once, we fought Aldo twice, we fought Mendez once. We haven't got a chance at the belt yet. But it's either I want belts... Or McGregor again. I know we just fought McGregor, but I like fighting the good guys, you know.
McGregor's not even in the top 10, so that's actually not looking good. Jose Aldo's falling down too now. We might get another chance at Mendez. McGregor might have switched weight classes, honestly, if he's not in the top 10 anymore. No, he's just falling into hard times. Damn, Connor. Down to 17th. That's a mighty big fall. You're pretty young, too, for you to go down that far. Lucas Silva is way down at 43. I wouldn't mind fighting him, but there's no way I'll ever get a chance at him. I wish I could pick my fights. That'd be awesome. If you got the belt and you could pick fights, that'd be amazing. Here's our chance. We got to fight at the belt. He's honestly worse than our like last four fighters we fought. He only has 85 ground. He's basically a worse version of me. I have better clinch than him. I have better stand up. I think I have the same ground as him. I'm not gonna say anything. I can't train. Oh, I've never had that before. I guess we just gotta jump right into the fight. But you know what? I think we can do it. I think we can easily beat him. Why does it say? Wait, what can I? Oh, I can't train something. I can't train clinch. Okay, I get it. I don't know what happens if I sim for a D grade. Will I get those? I will get them. There might just be a better chance of you getting hurt, honestly. I guess let's just try to get this a little bit better. There's nothing really we can keep working on here. Like we're pretty much maxed out on everything. Might as well go with our leg powers a bit more. Again, it doesn't really matter what we pick. We might as well go for the B though, I guess. Minus two toughness, but you know what? I think we're pretty much close to our max leg power, to be honest. Okay, here goes nothing, guys. I wanna think it's gonna be our easiest fight, just because I don't really know anyone on this lineup at all, really. I know Johnson. He actually lost, but other than that, I don't really know any of these guys. But I think this might be an easier fight than our last couple fights we had, because again, we have one less ground, we have like 5 better stand up, we have like 11 better clinch. I think Conor McGregor or Aldo might have been a tougher opponent than this guy is going to be, but I could jinx it. He could come out the gate swinging, you know, immediately stun me or something like that and get me in a bad situation. I don't know, I've never fought him before. He could be a beast. That's why he's
coming up.
That's why he has the title.
It's a featherweight title fight between Dennis Seaver and Pretty Boy.
What is it looking like? Do I have any? He's 16 years my elder. Damn.
Pretty Boy is 30.
I got 5 inches on him, but
Pretty
Boy is
5 inches taller.
He's 16. Damn. Damn. How are you holding? How are you holding the belt at 46? How are your bones not like breaking from like arthritis and such? I wonder if that means he has less toughness.
Man, coming off that knockout victory in his last UFC fight, his confidence is at an all-time high.
On break his leg.
Spectacular finish. He's looking for more of the same.
That's a big head kick there.
Big straight to the body by Seaver.
Oh, and break this dude's leg. Leg
kick. He's looking to slow his opponent down. He sees that coming and parries it away.
Our power is definitely noticeable in our legs.
With the strong combination. Now he's got the
actually, I wanted the tie. I don't know why I switched out of it. That's why I should have said. I want him to get up. I don't want this fight to go to the ground. I'm done with trying to fight on the ground. I want to kick his ass standing up. If he takes me down with a ground or with a takedown, that's fine. I'm just gonna try to get up from it as fast as I can like that. He can do that. I got 5 rounds to beat him standing up. I'm not gonna.
Nice hook.
We should have better like punch speed and stuff than him, because again, we have better stand up and everything than he does.
Head kick. Oh, that one hurt him. Big combination. Nice knee there. High kick. He hurt him.
Ooh, what is he trying to do there? He's like trying to do some weird sidekick. Let's see this replay here. That was an easy fight again.
Huge punch.
I can't really make it any more difficult. Like this is the most difficult run to get, so
But that was a pretty easy fight for a title fight, you know. I feel nice and spry and young. Like, give me an extra, like, 40 more fights before I have to retire, because you know what? No one's really... Look at that. That would have, like, broke his leg. He, like, twisted it. So weird.
He goes limp.
He, like, did the splits there, basically, and then, like, rolled his ankle, his right ankle that was planted on the ground. It kind of, like, rolled over itself. If you watch his right ankle right there, like, look at that. Ugh, that's like almost breaking your leg type shit there.
Has the official decision. Ladies and
gentlemen. We have our belt back once again. We actually have our second different, like, we're in the featherweight right now. Yeah, we have our second different belt so far, which is awesome. We had the lightweight for a while. We just didn't really have any tough opponents to fight anymore, so we moved weight classes, and now we are holding the featherweight belt. Where do we go from here? Like, we've beat everyone who's a, like, Bekic, I guess? I guess we could fight him, but we haven't fought him yet, but we beat Mendez, we beat Aldo's on the rise once again. I wouldn't mind fighting Max Holloway, but see, Mendez or Aldo again, honestly, like, fight challenge. What could be my fight challenge? I have the belt. Unless you're giving me, like, Anderson Silva and making me, like, jump up a few weight classes, I don't see what the fight challenge could be. It's either gotta be Bekic or Mendez. It's gotta be. Max Holloway. Okay, we fought this dude before, I'm pretty sure. Parry at least 10 strikes, hurt Max with any type of health event. Knock out Max before the end of the third round. Okay, that's doable. I wish I could fight someone better than that, though. That's kind of a disappointment. But anyways, I'm going to end the episode there. When we come back for next episode, we will fight Max Holloway and see how long we can defend this belt before we're forced into retirement. So peace out, guys. Thanks for watching.